Oops. Oops. I'll do that later. Oh, I don't want to tweet it out. One second. Oh, I should do this though. It's just like, can you not? Should I? Yeah, I should skip it because there's no need because I was already in the freaking mission when it freaking crashed. Hope it doesn't do it again.
What's the word, Captain?
We spotted one of Dutch's men about an hour ago. I think he took the bait.
Let's get in position then. Have your men ready to run them down.
Freaking Xbox is perfect. What am I saying? Xbox is perfect.
Are you ready to finish this, Mr.
Marston? Doesn't crash.
Yes, sir.
It's like, even though how, worse freaking my PS4 crashes, in the system UI when I'm playing a game, it rarely crashes, but it sometimes does happen. Yes. And it's like, I kind of can't forgive a game for crashing because it happens. But it's like, can you fucking stop doing that? Red Dead Redemption crashed on me twice. I forget where the first time it crashed on me.
Come and get me! Take them early! We'll kill you all!
Okay, someone just blew up the air. Throwing dynamite, that's annoying.
Now!
Well, it's they're not retreating. Really getting between
us, but whatever. Going after them.
Crashing karma and oh crap. Oh shoot. My nose was a sheep butt. Didn't want to accidentally bump the mic.
That wagon's out of control. It's coming straight out of our cavalry. I thought you wanted to kill me.
Was that supposed to happen? Yep. I'm not even too sure what the fuck just happened. Just because, the camera went all weird, like zoomed out, then paused for a few seconds, then zoomed back in and it, and my, the car flipped over. It's like, yes.
Now before I shoot you myself,
but at least we're all good.
The one person we have left that can appeal to Mr. Vanderlyn is the last person we know who knows him. Your wife.
That won't be necessary. Mr. Ross, Captain, let's go.
Freaking, I need to finish this game before it, like, just breaks at the seams. Oh I know they have something to say, but screw it, I'm not gonna wait for... Yeah, I'm not gonna go at their slow ass pace. Where are we going? Oh god damn this. Why is there always scary horses? Why does it do that? I don't know, I just not do that one, I guess. Because that one freaking like it opens. I don't know what. I don't know why it's doing that. Why are you... I don't understand that. That you were like ducking and that when you're like 50 feet or like more than 50 feet away from blast rhythms. Or the blast zone, whatever. Like, do you really expect the freaking dynamite blast like that much? I don't know how much The blast radius for a single TNT is... For a single TNT signal. Stuck on a stupid dead body.
This is the United States Army. Worship the Lord above.
Oh, God damn it.
Push into the village. Come on, let's finish this. Marston, use that Gatling gun. We'll take him out from the ridge.
There we go.
Sorry about
that. Must be good. But the people started to disappear.
Take two men with us. The rest will stay here and take care of the wounded. They'll plant charges at the gate. You and I will provide the cover fire. All right, man. Blow that gate open. Get ready to hold off their fire, Marston. Up top! Cover them! Come on! What are you doing? Shoot them!
You clearly don't like me!
Thank you.
It's like I don't know what you want me to do.
Hold them off! We need time to set the explosives!
There we go.
Looks like it's me and you, John. You should have stayed at home. You better follow me. Son of a bitch! God damn it! Never take me alive, John!
Oh.
It's over, John. I ain't leaving here without you.
Okay. Oops. Miss Cabin. Went upstairs, I'm pretty sure. It leads into a freaking mining shaft.
You're just like me, John. You can't change who you are. I ain't like you.
Where is this fucking ladder? Seriously, I don't understand. Oh. I think I have to turn the brightness up. Because seriously, I don't understand. There's a ladder here. Yes. Oh. Yeah, I need to turn up the brightness. Okay. So, I'm gonna take that off. Whoa. I almost dropped that. And turn up the brightness. That's a little better. I don't know how much better though. But hopefully that's enough. Oh god damn it. I really need something else in this stupid remote to put these freaking to put my phone on. Because obviously, like, yeah, it's a little better. Not a huge amount, but still.
I ain't like you.
I'll take a little better over nothing. Well, because I don't want it too bright, obviously. Hurry up.
You can't erase the past, John. Him and me, it won't make it go away.
That's where you're wrong.
Okay. Jeez, it's
hello again, John.
It's a hello, bit John. Better
we gotta stop
inside because I couldn't see sure. Anything, but outside it's just retarded.
Plan,
well, not really retarded, but it's a hell of a lot brighter, and it kind of hurts.
I don't doubt it.
It's too bright.
Fight nature. John, we can't fight change.
I wish it would auto-adjust.
Gravity. We can't fight nothing. My whole life, all I ever did was fight.
Then give up, Dutch.
But I can't give up, neither. I can't fight my own nature. That's a paradox, John.
But I turned down the brightness again. Since I don't need it that bright now. That's kinda annoying.
They have to. Because they have to justify their wages.
That's their business.
Our time has passed.
Oh no. Freaking when he hit the ground, I mean when he hit the rock side, you didn't see any blood. But now you do, obviously.
It looks better in the report that way.
Where's my family?
Your wife was killed in a prison riot last week. So, I'm only joking, dear boy. They were sent back to that Scrabble ranch of yours in Beecher's Hope. They're quite safe and sound.
They better be.
Thank you, Mr. Marston, for everything. I know this wasn't easy for you, but I have to say, done your country proud.
Yeah, exactly. See you around, John. Try to stay out of trouble. Come on, Archer. Let's go find somebody else we can annoy.
Let's go!
Now I know. Oh, where is that? And there we go. I don't know. I don't do that. Oops. Well, getting off the horse.
Abigail! Jack! Anyone here? Anyone home? Oh, darling. I never thought I'd see this day again.
You no good hillbilly piece of shit! I thought you was dead! I thought you was dead, John, huh? Where you been? Where you been?
You know where I've been, darling. You know.
You saw Dutch, didn't you?
Yeah, I saw him.
And Bill?
Yeah, I saw him too.
And you didn't go back to him?
I left that life. Just as you left yours. How'd they treat you?
Oh, I can take care of myself, John. One guard got funny on me one time, but I wasn't so ladylike and he didn't try it again. Nor no one else.
How's the boy?
Oh, like you. And like me. Well, he's like a kid growing up without a father.
That ain't fair.
What is fair?
Well, some trees flourish, others die. Some cattle grow strong, others are taken by wolves. Some men are born rich enough and dumb enough to enjoy their lives. Ain't nothing fair, you know that.
We tried to change, I mean, ain't that what you're supposed to do?
We did change. And it's over now. Jack! Jack, come here, boy.
Hello, sir.
Come here. How you been?
Coyotes ate all the chickens and poachers took the cattle. I tried, Father. I tried.
I know you did, son. I know.
And don't you go blaming me, boy. Don't you go blaming me.
I ain't blaming no one, old man, but since you're still alive, there's four mouths to feed. And no cattle.
That's a nice way to greet somebody. Why don't I get the warm and tender embrace?
Consider the fact I ain't put a bullet in your embrace, old man. You were supposed to look after the place.
I did. Well, I did my best. Thing is, there was too many of them. I thought you was dead. I wasn't drinking.
Hold your excuses until you figured out which one to use. Jack, go get your bags packed, boy. We got work to do. We leave in the morning. Go on.
Yes, sir.
Where are you going?
Well, it's getting kind of dark now, but in the morning we've got to go get ourselves some more cattle.
I've got friends at McFarland's ranch. It's over in Hennigan's stead who can sell us some.
Now, Abigail, I hope you've learned to cook.
Yes. Didn't I say? Rather than some prison, they actually kept me incarcerated in a cooking school for young ladies.
How do you do, sir?
All right. We should get moving.
How you feeling, Jack?
I'm feeling fine, sir.
We got a decent ride ahead of us.
I've never been to Hennigan's Stead. How do you know these ranchers?
I met them while I was away. The McFarlands are good people. We need folks we can trust right now.
How?
I was sick and they looked after
me. Sick how?
You sure got a lot of questions.
I don't often get a chance to ask them. Was it a gentleman's complaint? What do they call it? The morning drip?
Good God, boy, no! Where do you learn these things?
Uncle told me about it.
Well, he'd know, the dirty old fool. No, I just got weak for a while. Acted foolishly, got in trouble. Guess I was a little out of practice.
Hey, Pa!
What?
Where were you all that time? Where'd you go?
What'd your mother tell you?
She said it was some kind of important government business.
That's about right. Some people thought I owed them some favors.
Why did they take us away?
They thought it wasn't safe for you here by yourself. Those men harm you?
No, they're okay. Some of them even told me stories. I think I'd like to be a government man one day. Or a politician.
Come on!
Was it something to do with Mr. Dutch and Bill? Why you went away?
Who told you that?
I kept hearing people say their names. That's all.
Yeah, I caught up with Bill and Dutch. We had some old business needed settling.
Where are they now?
They're gone, son. We won't be seeing them again.
They were angry at you, weren't they? That's why we had to leave.
They was just good men who turned bad. I'll explain it to you one day.
And what does that make you?
I guess I'm a bad man who tried to be a good father. I don't know. Every man has a right to change. A chance of forgiveness. Ain't that what the good book says?
You've never read me the good book, sir.
Well, I imagine that's what it says.
I'm guessing this is going to end in 30 minutes time. 30 more minutes.
I thought I'd never see again. Have our public servants in Blackwater sent you back on another homicidal errand to protect and save us from Lord only knows what?
Thankfully not, sir. I was hoping you might still be able to sell me some cattle.
My boy, it would be a pleasure. Bonnie's out to Crow now. She'll be more than happy to help you.
Take care now, Mr. McFarland. Good luck.
Oh.
Yeah. All right, Jack. You're gonna have an important job. I want you to lead the herd while I drive them from the back. Keep us all moving in the right direction.
Oh, please say don't have a freaking leader herd again.
My eyes deceive me. A devil walks among us.
I said I'd be back when this was all over, Miss McFarland. After the barn fire, you remember?
Of course I remember. I just didn't believe a word of it. So, you've come for some cattle?
Yeah, I'm finally starting up my farm again. Or trying to, at least.
You'll be fine. You've been taught well. Come on, then.
Those two are done. I just turn it off then. Put it in. Oh, I have to. Why?
Let's go. Head for the river, son.
Why do I have to? Do this.
Load up now.
Good luck, John. Come back and see you sometime.
So, what happened? Last I heard, you were headed for some exotic escapade in Mexico.
It's a long story. Too long to tell without a drink in my hand.
Go.
Come on.
Well,
I think we We haven't had much time to talk yet.
Well, I'm glad you're back together again.
It's gonna take some time. We've all been through a lot. Come on. How's the ranch?
We're surviving, but it hasn't gotten any easier.
If you're still struggling, there's not much hope for me.
Whoa. Looks like you got him under control. I best get back to Pa.
Nice to see you again, Miss McFarland. And thanks for everything.
Call me Bonnie, you don't.
All right, Jack. Let's get him through the river.
News this could be worse, I guess.
Yeah. Hold up, Jack. This don't look right. Stay back, son. I'll hold them off. That's all of them. Jack, wait there, I'm coming. You all right? You're not hurt, are you?
No, I'm fine. I wasn't scared, honest.
Sorry you had to see that, son. Those men won't be stealing from anybody else. Jack, head left up the road towards home.
I know where I'm going, Paul.
Let's go.
Oh, he lost 3 cows. Oh well. I'm guessing they get shot.
So we're ranchers now?
Did a good job, son. Nice shooting.
Thanks, Paul.
Make a rancher of you yet. the book,
Jesus, boy. That looks like some bony-ass finger.
Well, it's an adventure, sir. Set out in the West, and it tells this amazing story of how people killed the savage Redskins, and how this man, this brave man, hunts the man who killed his father.
I'm glad you're enjoying it. Talking of adventure, how'd you like to learn to track elk? Really big ones in the valley this time of year. We could use the meat.
Well,
I know you'd rather read your adventures. Trust me, this can be very enjoyable in its own way. I suppose maybe it's a little less dramatic. So, let's go, come on. You may get to see me get gored by some massive wild beast. Then you can write a story about that.
Very funny, Paul. I've forgotten how funny you was.
Grab your things.
Yeah, it's like... I don't know after a while that's... whatever.
What are you doing? Let's keep moving!
Alright, now stay close to the dog, son! When he finds something, you stay back and I'll show you how to make a kill.
Whatever you say, sir.
You sure you're ready for this?
I guess so.
Now the trick to hunting is calm and patience. You gotta think and move like an animal to catch an animal.
A rifle helps, doesn't it?
Elk don't stand still, son.
I wouldn't know. This is the first time you've taken me hunting.
There's lots of things I ain't done with you. But I'm gonna try and make up for that. You don't seem too excited about this.
What do you want me to say, Paul? Yippee?
Are you sure you're all right? I mean, I know all that business must have been hard on you.
It wasn't nothing. I'm not a kid anymore.
Well, it won't happen again. It's over.
Until the next time you meet him?
Jack, he's on to something. There won't be a next time.
Don't make no more promises, Paul. I've heard them all before.
You know, one time I hunted a bear up in tall trees. You never seen a bigger animal in all your life.
I read this story about a girl who was raised by wolves. She'd hunt goats with them and everything.
Sounds like a tall yarn to me.
Taller than a boy being taken from his home and locked up in a dungeon?
I'm just saying. Maybe you spend too much time with your head in those books.
I thought you had all wanted me to read.
Look, I see one.
Yeah, I see it.
It seems to me like... to be honest, Rockstar didn't know how to end this game.
Come on, I'll show you how to cut the meat.
I thought he was gonna get away. That was great, Paul.
You just gotta wait for the right shot, not rush it.
That's a big one.
This meat should fetch a decent price in Manzanita.
What do you mean you gotta wait for the right shot? I shot him like three times and that was it.
Alright, let's see if we can find some more.
Let's go!
Come on!
There's no time for rest! You can do it, Rufus!
Ready to take a shot, Jack?
Of course, Paul.
Remember, it's all about timing. Wait for your moment. Don't snatch at it.
I know. I saw how you did it.
If you say so. All right. When he finds him, you take the lead. Come on, boy. Find us something.
Find another one, Rufus.
What is it, Rufus?
You can do it, Rufus!
There they are! Jack, come on! Yeah!
That's it, son.
He's over there!
Don't rush it.
Let's go.
Get after him.
Can I?
Jack, now it's your turn. Let's go.
Come on.
Now come on, let's get this meat over to the trading post at Manzanita.
Hey, watch it!
This is a mess. Good, son.
Can't we shoot some more?
Only kill what you need. We'll go out again soon.
No, I didn't think I was gonna like it.
I told you you'd have fun, didn't I? Let's go. Here we are.
Yeah, we're gonna sell all the pelts.
Doing business with you.
I'm glad it doesn't do that. Where you sell too many of one thing and the price for that said item goes down in price. Well, selling price, I should say.
Never you mind. Enough to keep Rufus out of the stewing pot for a couple days.
And what about me? What do I get?
You get to eat, son.
but I did half the work. That isn't fair.
What can I say? I'm another corrupt landowner.
I'll be rich one day, then you'll see.
I sure hope so. And you can look after us when we get old.
What do you mean, get old? You are old.
We ain't old. Uncle's old.
Well, he should be in a museum.
Yeah, preserved in whiskey for the next 1,000 years. So, you enjoy your first hunting trip?
It was great, Paul.
Herding cows, hunting elk. You're growing up. Proud of you.
I always told you I wanted to help.
You know, you and me, if we work hard, we can make something of this farm.
I'd like that.
And thank you for looking after your mother. She said you were very brave.
I tried to be strong, like you told me. But Ma, she can look after herself.
Oh, Pa, that was so much fun. I can't rightly believe it. Just like in the books.
We'll do it again soon. Now get to your chores. What you cooking?
Same thing I've been cooking the past 15 years with the hope of poisoning you.
Ain't working so well.
Not yet.
Be honest, though. Tastes bad enough to kill a man.
I never was much of a cook, but I did try to be a good wife.
And you have been.
Given what we was and what we came from, I think we've...
I'm pretty, in this stream after this game.
I look at him and I think we've been blessed. Maybe he can be something more.
He's a good kid.
Like officially ending, I'm probably not gonna play another game.
Railroads and government, and motor cars and everything gone and done away with all that.
And he ain't gonna marry no orphaned working girl running with a bunch of hucksters, neither.
If he meets one like you, I hope he'll marry her.
Stop. For an illiterate gunslinger, you sure know how to make a girl blush.
God damn crows! John! You have got to go deal with them. They've broken into the silo again and are eating all the corn out from it.
Of course, my angel.
Wait, get out of there!
All right, all right.
Come on! Scat! Shh.
Where do I have to go? I love when they run away from you. Okay, cool. Don't give me any markers or anything. Okay, don't give me any markers. Oh, there was a marker. It just went away for some reason. Lost too much corn. Okay. But, yeah, don't give us a freaking marker or anything. Seriously, give me a marker.
Not bad.
How are you?
Go to bed one more time, I guess. Does tell you like when it's faded you can't, but when it's lit up you can. Okay.
Something you ain't telling me?
Bonnie McFarlane. She's a friend. Saved my life when I went after Bill and nearly got myself killed again.
Oh, now you two's in the habit of sending each other letters. How very nice.
It weren't nothing like that. What's it say?
I don't know. I can't. Well, you know I can't read.
Give it here.
You read that thing out loud.
I ain't hiding nothing. Dear Mr. Marston, stop. Need corn sacks. Stop. Emergency. Stop. Weevils and moths ate entire county supply. Stop. Can you help? Not exactly the most romantic request, now, is it?
I guess not. She saved your life, you say?
Yes, ma'am.
Well, then you're gonna have to help her and her family out. We've got a plentiful supply of corn sacks over near the silo. About the one thing Uncle didn't manage to have stolen while we was gone.
Okay.
Hurry back, John. And John, what's she like?
You know. A little bit like you, I guess. She's a woman in a man's world.
Oh, there we go. Shoot.
Change my mind. I'm coming with
you.
What are you waiting for? We better hurry.
Oh, I gotta hurry and deliver this. Yeah.
I don't think I can let you go off again without me.
Fair enough. I'm glad of the company. You only had to ask.
Ask? I was waiting for you to ask me.
I thought you'd want to keep an eye on the boy.
Oh, while you were off supporting with cowgirls in the next county? I don't think so, John Marston. You only just got home. That Jack's seen enough of me for a lifetime. She married.
Oops.
Bonnie McFarlane.
I didn't mean to knock them off their horses.
Normal? What? Normal like me?
No. Normal as in two eyes. Mouth.
Okay.
No, that kind of normal. Besides, ain't no woman fine as you.
A little flattery. Now we're finally getting somewhere.
If you find yourself in a hole, first thing to do is stop digging.
Another pearl of wisdom from John Marston. I sure do miss those.
I never took you for the jealous type, Abigail.
I ain't jealous so much as curious.
You heard what she wrote. It's just some corn. She saved my life and she was decent enough to me, so I owe her this much at least.
How did she
half dead on the side of the road and took me to the doctor.
I'm not exactly a pro driver.
Bill didn't take so kindly to me visiting on it now.
Bill never did like surprises. How was he?
Same as he was when we left. Angry and dumb. Taking his revenge out on the world. People down there was really scared of him.
A Bill? You gotta be kidding me. He was only frightening if he was afraid of dumb fools.
Bill weren't so bad, but when Dutch went crazy, Bill took it.
God damn it. Oh, are you kidding me from the start?
John, wait! Maybe I should meet this McFarlane woman. Well, come on, man. Let's get going.
I'm gonna be really careful there. Going across bridges. There we go.
She saved my life and she was decent enough to me, so I owe her this much at least.
How did she save your life anyway?
She found me half dead on the side of the road and took me to the doctor. Most folks would have left me there.
Half dead from what?
Bill didn't take so kindly to me visiting unannounced.
Bill never did like surprises. How was he?
Same as he was when we left. Angry and dumb, taking his revenge out on the world. People down there was really scared of him.
A Bill? You gotta be kidding me. He was only frightening if he was afraid of dumb fools.
Bill weren't so bad, but when Dutch went crazy, Bill took it hard.
For a while, we all thought we'd found something right. Better way to live, but it was just a lie. So you saw before they did.
Maybe, but they was still kind of a family.
A family that left you for dead. You knew the truth. John, and they hated you for it.
Where did they take
you? Who?
Those children bastards.
I'm trying to reposition myself about more stuff off.
Can't have been too far from here, though.
They treat you right?
It ain't the first time I've had a gun to my head, John. You're forgetting your marriage proposal.
Very funny.
No, they learned pretty quick what would happen if they laid a finger on me.
Sons of
it wasn't them or being there. I didn't care about that. I've been in far worse situations.
You came. Thank you so much. We lost the entire harvest.
Miss McFarlane, I'd like you to meet my wife, Abigail.
Oh, ain't you quite the gentleman all of a sudden? It's a pleasure to meet you, Mrs. Marston.
Likewise. Thank you for saving my husband's life. And for teaching the miserable goats manners, among other things.
I didn't teach him anything. I know better than to try to change a man. You should meet my father.
Oh, people can change, Miss McFarlane. John and I have to believe that more than anybody.
This is a decent first harvest for you, John. You should be proud. That's good land you got there.
How are you feeling, Mrs. Marston? From what your husband told me, it must have been awful for you.
I've been through worse, and I knew he'd be back before too long. He can't cook a meal to save his life.
Abigail, in my darkest hours, when I was most homesick, just the thought of one of your rat meat stews kept me pushing forward.
Well, about as amusing as a weeping saddle sore, ain't he, Mr. Farland? If you're gonna start yammering about women's work, John, I'd say you might. happy in the wrong company.
I'd say so, too.
I never felt so outnumbered.
I think she likes me. I easily start where I'm guessing.
Sometimes I think I was the stupid one for believing I could get out. Maybe Dutch, Bill, and Javier were just being honest with themselves.
You ain't perfect, John, and I sure ain't. But you're better than they are, than they were. Speed it up, John. You're driving like Uncle.
Maybe we can't change, but we gotta try, for Jack's sake. Even if we have to start again 100 times, it's better than going back to what we were. How's Jack doing?
Angry, upset. He's been through a lot.
I hope he's gonna be all right.
It's gonna take time. For a while, his world was safe, normal even. Then it got turned upside down again.
He ain't saying much about it.
I tried to talk to him, but how do you explain any of this? What do you say when he asks about Uncle Bill and Uncle Dutch? They were family when he was a little boy.
He hides away in those books of his.
Wouldn't you? It ain't like the real world's done him many favors. He's just been kidnapped. He grew up with the gang. That's no life for a boy.
We did our best to protect him.
Come on, John. He saw things no boy should see.
Well, now we got a chance to make it right.
Quite a way.
Good day, John. I guess I better go fix us something to eat.
Mm-hmm. you can't. Of course you can't. What? Okay.
You're tensing up.
I'm not.
You are. Your back's tense and it's making the rifle jump. You're holding it wrong. Here, let me show you.
I don't need you to show me, Paul.
I guess not.
No showing, you'll just run off again or something.
Jeez.
Better I teach myself.
I ain't going nowhere.
Whatever you say, Paul.
Don't be like that.
Sorry.
Wolf's been after the herd. Gotta get out there and scare him off. You wanna come with me? Safer with two.
Okay.
Never mind. Oh, there we go. I thought, my mic, I messed up my mic when I snapped. I guess it didn't. That was something, I guess.
You know that. Why you gotta treat me like a kid?
It's what fathers do. I'm just trying to look out for you.
Be a father when it suits you. What about the rest of the time?
Come on, Jack. That ain't exactly fair.
One minute you're telling me to be a man, the next you're telling me I'm just a boy.
It's gonna take a while for things to get back to me.
Where are you?
Oops. This scratch my ear. What are we hunting?
Look, son! He sniffed him out! Let's go! Slow down! That's your luck, my friend. I need to bring
you. Why are you pointing that at me?
Don't let him get too close!
I'm skinning all these. I'm not gonna waste them.
Damn it! They're coming at us! You stink!
Whoa! Come on!
Get him, Jack! Go!
What do I do? I'm not gonna shoot a freaking animal just to shoot it. Are you kidding me? Oh, thought he died.
Remember what I told you. Down you come.
I can't stop now. This one's mine. We can't do this on foot, can we?
Why did you say that?
Listen, Nas.
Take this! I'll get him!
Come on! Keep your head straight! Killing and murdering.
Not for the person who's dead.
No. And I guess I've been both. That's how it goes. We all do what we have to survive. Sometimes it ain't pretty. And in the end, we pay the price for what we did.
Like those rustlers who attacked our cattle?
Exactly. Look, when I was a kid, things were different. Rules were different, but that's over now. Kill a few wolves.
Well, I read a book about a father and son who robbed banks. What arm will? That was his name.
I'm happy with my two arms, if you don't mind.
Just imagine it, though. John and Jack Marston, those wanted men in the West.
And what about your mom?
Well, I mean, we still come home.
You live in a dream world. It ain't like they tell it in books. And it ain't no way to live life. It was ugly and brutal.
All right, jeez. I was only joking around.
You'll have a farm of your own. You can read and write. Don't waste your life, son. Don't live like I had to.
Let's go.
You're turned into a decent hunter, son. But try to stay out of trouble.
How long is this gonna be? One more time. I should do it. Yeah, it looks like that's good enough.
John!
What is it, old man?
It's Jack. The kid. Well, I just saw him out in the valley. Seems your tales of hunting got the better of him. He said he was going up the pass.
What's stuck in his ear?
Kid can't hunt a grizzly. Thing will eat him alive.
I know. I tried to stop him.
But you're worthless as a lawyer at a lynching. Damn you, old man. This is my son. Anything happens to him, you wish it was you that bear attacked.
Come on, Rufus.
Oh, there we go. I wanted the gun with 10 bullets. Well, I could hold 10 bullets. I wanted that one.
That's it. Good boy. What you got, boy? Can you smell something? You can find him, boy.
Oh yeah, I remember the Bigfoot thing.
Come on, Rufus! Find Jack!
In this game, they said,
answer me!
Well, I think it was a mod where you could see, Bigfoot, but it wasn't in the Rockstar said it wasn't in Red Dead Redemption. I think San Andreas was fake too, where it had a Bigfoot. Let me shoot it 10 times.
Don't move! Keep your head down!
I think that was overkill.
Get you home.
are you doing?
Yeah, I think so.
You're lucky to be alive, you stupid boy. What'd I tell you about going off by yourself?
I go off by myself plenty. You just don't know about it. You're never around.
So this is my fault? You disobeyed me.
I was trying to prove myself.
Prove what? By getting yourself killed?
You're always telling... Come on, Pa. I'll keep quiet, I promise.
I never said that.
I just thought if I could do something you'd like, maybe you wouldn't go away again.
Son, I ain't going anywhere. And believe me, neither are you for a real long time.
What if we were just gonna die? Why did the horse just...
Come along.
That makes no sense.
You'd be a pile of bones right now.
What would you get? I'm just a nuisance to you anyway.
That ain't true, Jack. I'd do anything for you. You know that.
I guess there's only room for one girl in this family.
Trust me, son.
Freaking stupid horse.
I'm just glad you're safe.
Oh, please don't stop. I don't feel too good.
God damn it, how long do we have to wait now? Oh, there it is.
Going after a grizzly? What were you thinking? You've only been hunting twice.
Why are we stopping? I'm not a little kid anymore. What are you doing at my age? I don't think I can ride myself, sir.
Bad things. Things nobody should do. But your mom and me, we didn't
have
what you
had.
Keep going, Pa. I want to get home.
Whoa there.
Yeah, I know.
This is retarded.
I'm not asking you to be grateful. I'm asking you to do what I say before you get yourself killed.
It's always one set of rules for you and another set for everybody else. You think I don't know what you did back in the old days? I'm not stupid.
You could have fooled me.
You think I didn't sit up and listen to Dutch and Bill telling all those stories? You think I don't know who you are?
It ain't no secret I didn't get these scars falling over in church.
But nobody tells me anything. You and Ma pretend like nothing happened.
We just want a better life for you, son. Now rest. We'll have you home soon. Come on.
It's like I skinned the horse because it was dead anyway, so why not get some money from it? It's just so stupid you could do things like that.
Sorry I made you worry, Pa.
Don't be too eager to grow up, son. Ain't as much fun as it looks. When you're ready to hunt bears, I'll take you.
Ranger, danger. I don't know why. Where is the stranger? He's right there. Oh, there's another thing, I think. No. It's just... whatever. Oh, I have the deed for a war horse. Oops. I didn't know he could do that. I just totally pushed his cart over. Oops. Oh, I didn't have to do this, but oh well. I didn't know I could just totally push a freaking thing over his cart. But I am excited to see what freaking JRPGs, freaking Xbox gets. If they get Yakuza, it's like, oh well. It's like the, I don't know what to say, Kiryu's storyline is over. And it's like, yes, they were, they're doing the remakes of Yakuza, but it's like, I don't know what to say. They're like, I don't know, I don't know, the Yakuza 3 remake, even though it's new, it's just a remake of like, I don't know, of a probably 12-year-old game. So it's like that's cool, but at the same time it's like, who cares? I think it's the same with what is it? Oh yeah, Disgaea 1 Complete. I think it's also coming to Xbox. And it's like, That's probably a 15 plus year old game. It's like, I'm not gonna lie and say, oh, that's cool for the people who want to play that game, but it's like, I don't know, it's not bragging, right? It's like, oh, we got a PS4 exclusive, good for you. I played that, well, at least Yakuza 3, I played it a few years after it came out. So what? But it's like, it could be because this frickin' fanboy stupidness is just getting way, way and way more stupid to me. Because it is. It's like, who cares? If so-and-so game comes to your platform and not comes to one platform, then later down the road it gets some freaking ported to another console. It's like, sure, that's cool, but I don't understand why people, fanboys, like, freak out about that. It's like, cool. Cool, it's just a business. That's all it is.
Fingers that ain't what they used to be. I'd love it. Sure, bring me any pretty ones you find, huh?
I don't know. Okay. I need to do a mission with Uncle, but he's never there. Does he sleep outside without a bed?
Well, thank the good Lord you're back. Nothing worse for an old man than sleeping in the warm afternoon sun.
Seriously, what did he do?
That can be arranged. It'll cost me less than food.
You always
it's just he a handful of shit.
You always was a useless, conniving thief.
And where's them cattle? Did you take them to pasture?
It's coming around to that.
When exactly?
It's easy to pick on the elderly.
I don't know, it's not brown enough for that. But it's like, what the hell happened? Unless you're really sick. It's more of a greenish color. I don't think they had mustard back then. Oh, please, please don't make me.
Let's move them out.
Again. Awesome.
Let's keep them moving now.
Why do they make you do this so many times? It's like I get it, that it was a tutorial, so they did it then. But it's the end of the game. Why are you making me do this? Get to the why are we transporting them again anyways?
Come
on, let's go! Oops. No, there we go. I'm gonna turn off my phone. We'll put sleep because I don't need it anymore. I'll just do that. What? What the hell did you do? Freaking nerds, idiots. The hell?
If you don't stop that, you ain't gonna live. Okay,
I think we're safe. Thank you. I thought we were done for.
Just helping out. Now you take care. Let's go.
We're safe. Old habits die hard, I see. You'll never learn.
Shut it, old man. Come on, let's get this herd moving again. Whoa, whoa. Come on, easy up now.
We only have 11 out of 15. I guess it's just the other fucking cows just slammed into the fucking trap. Idiots. Link our cows? Really this dumb?
ride back.
No thanks. You got your pound of flesh from me today.
Let's go. Come on.
Really? This is taking longer than I thought.
Let's go.
Like when the frickin' when the thing crashed, I thought like oh no, it won't take longer. Do not have Billy go pick. How many do I need?
Come on, no
more. Okay. How many do I need though? Whatever, I just don't have enough. I don't know how much is enough, but whatever. Jesus, how far are you? Oh, you're just right here. Five AM and 5 PM. Yeah, I should have said that. I tired of what that crashing is and oh no. Oh well. I just retired of the freaking video to that.
What are you looking at, old man?
There's some Mustangs and some such out there beyond that ridge. Wondering if it's worth getting you and going around some of them up.
Fair enough. We're nearly out of money. Ranch is in turmoil. We may not make it through the winter. What could we possibly want with some good quality horses? Come on.
That tone of voice ain't so becoming on you. Makes you seem all pent up and angry like some Blackwater would-be business tycoon with a bad case of hemorrhoids.
I'll give you a bad case.
Stopping here would be absolutely stupid. I'm not gonna do that. Because
are you gonna man up
we here? Must be retardedly close to the end. I don't know how much, obviously.
Come on, follow me. Why you gotta act so biggity all the damn time? What happened to you?
What were you gonna do? Just look at them horses all day?
Well, God forbid I'd do anything around here without checking with His Royal Highness first.
Yeah, you're real good at watching. That's about all you're good for, apart from bending your elbow.
I can't do right for doing wrong. You're an ungrateful bastard, you know. I did my best when you was gone.
Your best is like anybody else's worst.
Come on. I'm getting old. I gotta start taking things easy.
You've been taking things easy for 40 years.
Have to do. Oh, that's what we have to
do.
Come
on, rope one of them. What are you waiting for? Quick, throw that rope. Now. Don't let go. Whoa.
Stop talking, damn it. Relax now. Almost got you.
Freaking right in the sun, I cannot see.
It's all right. That's it.
Uncork that front, boy.
Quiet, old man. Relax now. Nearly there.
Finally. I got this one for you. Stop messing around and get back on your horse. Mount back up, you fool!
Well, I'm trying to, but he keeps running away from me. Freaking, I didn't choke out that horse at all. Where are the horses?
Come on.
Can I just... Oh. Yeah, I want to see that because there's probably more new anime on Funimation.
That's enough for now. Let's get him back to the ranch. Let's go!
That weren't half bad for a couple of old reprobates.
I learned a few things while I was away.
Anything you wanted to know, you only had to ask me.
You? What the hell do you know about any of this?
I was a rancher myself back in the day.
Firstly, I don't believe you. And secondly, if you was...
What?
Come on.
Look at these here horses. Fine as cream gravy. It sure will be nice to have some money in our pocket.
Any money we make's going straight back into this ranch, not down your gully.
Oh, come on. I ain't working for free here.
You ain't working at all. That's the problem, old man.
What about today? And all them cattle I herded? I'm always sucking hind kid around here.
You got food in your belly, ain't you? A roof over your head?
You're so tight. You get out of bed to turn over so as not to wear out the sheets.
Don't push your luck.
A little bottle wouldn't hurt, though. Something to ease an old man's aches and pains.
This is why they say, make sure there's enough fresh hay. We need to keep them strong.
All right. Damn, a little gratitude wouldn't kill you. Not a bad day's work.
Come on.
Okay, new items. How long does this go on for? Maybe this is the last.
Hey, Paul.
Need a hand with that?
The second to last mission.
Looks like you have. You know, you're real good with them tools.
Thank you, Paul.
You'll make this land real nice one day. Me and your mother? Do our part. By the time your turn comes, hell, this could be the nicest farm in the county.
Maybe, Paul.
Just gotta learn to shoot straight or you'll get yourself eaten by some animal.
Very funny, Paul.
Thank you, son. Soon it'll be quail season. We should have some fun then.
Is there anything you don't like shooting, Paul?
Well, I ain't met the thing yet, but as soon as I do, I'll let you know. You can even put it in one of them books you read.
Yeah, maybe I'll do that. The day John Marston stopped shooting.
No, I ain't no literary man.
Yeah, I don't know. I don't sure, why not? Like even though it's a stupid
right there,
title. Why not?
So, you ever hear talk about them machines that can make a man fly?
What is he doing?
You know, they're gonna be bringing one of those machines around the country.
I just noticed
when them machines can turn men into angels.
Uncle, what the hell is he doing?
John, come here, quick.
He's looking at something, but what the hell is...
Take a look at that.
Jack. Go into the house, lock all the doors. Whatever happens, don't come
outside.
Oh
yeah, this is the second last mission.
Come here, son. Whatever happens, keep the doors locked and your mother inside. Promise me.
God, watch your beard, dude.
Who is it, Paul?
It's just some old friends. You know, we'll take care of it.
Yeah, your beard and your mustache. Oh, it's just that.
Then run!
Yeah, run, boy!
Well, old man, looks like things is about to get settled once and for all.
So it seems.
Christ alive! There's still time for you to... Come on now! I did what you wanted! What the hell do they want?
I got a bullet here in a minute.
You said this was over.
It's probably not, because you're a part of Dusty's gang, even though you turned your back on him. Still part of Dusty's gang.
Come on! Can't stay out here! Go check on your family, boy.
What are we gonna do now?
What's wrong? What's happened?
Stay inside, you hear? Like I said, there'll be more coming.
Paul, what do they want?
I don't know, son. Whatever it is, it ends here.
Come on, get into auto aim range. Where?
Watch your head. They letting fools like you into the army? I think they call this a
massacre. There we go.
Hang in there, Uncle. I'm gonna get you out of here safe.
Ain't time, John. Ain't gonna make it off this porch anyhow.
I think he's down and out. Because even though it's just one gunshot.
Uncle, please! Oh my God! They killed him!
Come on, son! Ain't nothing we can do for him now! We're leaving the the farm. I'll watch from the silo. You two go to the barn. Get the horses ready.
John!
I'll meet you there.
Dog.
Until I got you covered. Come on, let's head for the barn. Now, quick, run for it. Come on, pick him off. All right, you're covered. Now go, go.
He's just shot his horse. Oof, shot that horse in the ass. When the hell did they get behind me?
Place to hide.
You're coming with us, Paul.
I'll catch up. Keep riding and don't look back. And don't be worrying about me, you hear? Now get going.
You stay out of trouble, John.
Ain't no trouble, Abigail. Ain't no trouble. I love you.
I love you.
Now go! Get!
What happened? Hello? God damn it, it freaking, oh no. Oh, I was supposed to hit, I was supposed to hit, the red eye, but it didn't, so it was like, So only a one more mission after this.
We have to go back for Pa.
Let's go.
Why did that suddenly slide down? Okay, it doesn't make sense. My phone just suddenly slid down. Okay, like I know it's kind of sleek, so yes, obviously it would fall. Or if that's word for it anyways, but okay, would you like to? Well, this is gonna...
Oh, bury me not on the lone prairie,
okay.
Where the coyotes wait.
Approximately it's... I'm guessing it's gonna be, gonna take, like, 8 more minutes. So yeah, freaking it took 30 minutes longer than I expected. Can I still do the stranger missions? The stranger danger missions? Oh, his mom died too.
Come on, fast!
Okay. Or was that his, was that his mom he saw? Or is that, I would guess so. You discover no items, yes. There should be one more mission. Where is it? Is it like... Is it kind of stupid? Like you have to do a bunch of things before you can do whatnot? I'm just gonna save, cause why not? And now there's what the hell happened there? You can't sleep here? God damn it. Did she be? Yeah, I don't remember how I do the last mission. Does he become a stranger mission? Like, what happens? Oh, I'll probably end it here and when I figure what I would do. When I figure out what I have to do, I'll probably like do a short stream. Probably like a really short stream, I don't know. I would do like to do a recording, but shoot, I can't do that, can I? I was gonna say like, where did we bury? Oh, there's Uncle's grave, there's Mom's grave, and there's Dad's grave, I'm guessing. I'm gonna go to Armadillo. See if I could purchase a rare weapon from the gunsmith. Because I'm really confused what I would do. I don't think that was only in the, at least I don't think that was only in the PS3 version that that you kill the guy who killed your father. I don't think that was a PS3 only thing. But the thing is, I can't. That may be 100% completion thing, and if that is, then screw that. I'm not doing 100% completion on this. I want to know where Armadillo is, though. Oh, there. Just because I want to go there to see if I could buy a rare weapon. Oh shoot, they're all close. I'll probably do that later though. I'm off stream, I'm getting a few trophies. Like, I'll probably get, what is it? Oh yeah, the hog tying a woodman and letting a train run over. I'm probably gonna... Do that one. Do that trophy.
Thanks very much.
Oh, really? There's nothing to buy? What about the general store?
Take care, sir. I'm selling some good tonics if you need them. Thank you.
Okay. Okay, I'll end it there then. Wait, what about this? Maybe this? Oh no, that, this is a general store.
Everything here is proudly made right here in the USA.
Worse pills? What the hell is that?
A fine choice.
Oh, I'm going to try and get this trophy. I don't know which horse I would buy though. That's a thing. I would buy like three horses. I don't know who. I don't know which horses though. Oh, that sucks. Well, that's another trophy I'll do offline, I guess. Because I know I would buy three horses from them, but I don't know which three horses though. So, yeah, that's freaking off-stream trophy, and I'm gonna search how to kill the law enforcer agent or whatever. Yeah, all it does is like you freaking go somewhere. He's like, you go to his wife, I think. You ask where this guy is. Then you go up to him and you say like, oh, I'm freaking John's son or whatever his name is. Oh, then you have a shootout, then obviously you win and that's the end. Like, it's nothing that special. Well, especially for 100%, it's nothing that special. Yeah, GTA 5 does something like that where you get 100% and I think something happens, I forget, but it's not that special if it doesn't stand out. If I can't remember it, yeah, it's nothing special. It's probably like just a phone call saying like, hooray, you did it, or something like that, something really stupid and not worth your time. But anyways, I'm gonna end this stream. Yeah, I should have ended it right when I became John Marston's son. But I was just looking for the extra mission, and you may have to be 100, like get 100% to do that. I don't remember. But anyways, I'll stop it for real this time, the stream. But before I do, I want to say thanks for all who did watch. And do all awkward stuff and goodbye. And I'll go Twitch and end the stream.